Welcome to Harp Explore. My name is Motoshi Kosako, harpist, composer, improviser. On this video series, I'd like to share interesting cutting-edge frontier of modern harp playing. In this month, I'm making a series of videos dedicated to Miles Davis. September 28th is the day he passed away in 1991. So I would like to celebrate his great achievement in jazz through these videos. Today, I picked a very famous popular song by Cyndi Lauper, Time After Time. And Miles Davis made a beautiful adaptation to his instrumental arrangement. Before my lecture, I would like to show the performance first. And if you are interested in what I'm doing, you can continue watching and then check my lecture part. But if not, just you can stop anytime. So I think it's fair. So I hope you enjoy Time After Time by Cyndi Lauper.
Thank you.
So this is the chord progression of time after time I use. And this version is key of C, actually original also the key of C. So your pedal position will be like this throughout the piece. So it means you can play this music on your lever harp. So the intro is a repetition of these two chords, F and then E minor. The same to outro and also the kind of interlude. And then the theme, section A goes like this. D minor on C, and then C major, okay? And then section B, F, G, E minor, F. And then these chords actually repeat, slightly different patterns, but they're repeating pretty much the same way. And then famous bridge, C section is G, A minor, and then, but this is actually F major seventh because our melody is E, so anyway. F, G, C, simple dominant motion. If you're interested, you just kind of write down on your paper and then continue the lecture part, and then you can understand what I'm doing better. For this type of music, most important element is the rhythm and the groove. And to keep the good rhythm, I mean, of course, you need to train yourself to be able to play in steady tempo. But besides that, actually, it's important to establish the nice accompaniment pattern, like a good bass line, also the good rhythm patterns you're repeating with the combination right and left hand. If you can embed this type of established pattern throughout the piece, you can give the impression to the audience that you are keeping a certain type of groove as if you were playing with a drummer and bassist. And if you just follow the melody and the chord progression and then play the piece like a very harpistic, and then you are missing the most important part of the tune. If you play this music like very harpistic, but actually it's just too cheesy and corny. And if you play this kind of pop song like this, actually it's not making this piece better. Actually, it's almost ruining the beauty of the piece. So, but at the same time, we are harpists, so we have to play within the limitation of the harp. But the advantage of harp is you can independent your left hand as a your built-in bass player. And if you can play a good bass line, and it makes the music more, how to call, more genuine, more authentic as a pop song. So, for example, an intro, F major chord and E minor chord kind of repeat. But that part is very spacious, but you want to keep the rhythm. So in that case, I often repeat the root kind of softly, and you can keep the groove, but at the same time, you can keep the feeling of spaciousness, like going like this. So something like that. And also on a theme, actually, we have like A, B, C, the different theme on this music. And the first theme is going to like And then here I established the bass line like a one, two, two, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two. So, and then right hand play like a. So, in a way, I play the bass line like this because I don't want to play left hand and right hand together because it makes the arrangement very thin in a way. But if you play kind of in a different timing between left and right hand, you can create illusion that multiple instruments playing together. So instead of playing like a, I play like this. And then B section. So here I establish the bass line with a slapping noise. Like this goes F major, G seventh, E minor, F major, F major, G seventh, E minor, E minor. So, and then the rhythm is 1, 2, 3, 4. So the when I stop the string, it makes a noise, but the noise is a part of the rhythm pattern. So something like that actually makes the performance very crisp. And then the voicing on right hand, this is simple F major, G7, E minor, F major. But I embed a tension note inside to make it a little more tasteful. So instead of playing, this is just a F, A, C, G, B, D, E, G, B, F, A, C. So instead of playing like that, I play on F, I actually include G, F major ninth, and I keep the G. And then I just play simple G. Oh, you can also play G major ninth too, including A. So A, B, and D. So it's your choice. But I often just keep the G. So play the simple G major chord. Next E minor, and then I try to include seventh chord, and which is D. And F, and I try to play the seventh again. This is the E. So last E minor chord, I also play seventh chord, and then D and E connect to each other. This kind of voicing sounds cool. And then C section is famous. And here I establish other bass line. So G, D, G, A, B, G, and the same pattern, A, E, A, B, C, A. And then right hand, this is a little thing, so I add just B when I'm playing D. Or you can play like this. But this is a little bit harder, so. And on this C chord, I play C, G, E, D, C, G. So going like this. And for improvisation, this kind of piece is really hard to improvise because no modulation and no jazzy chord progression. So the safe place to improvise is beginning and the kind of interlude. This is like an intro chord progression pattern, outro chord progression pattern. And also, this piece has a very nice modal part in the A section. This is basically repeating D minor on C and then C major. And then I established the accompaniment pattern to do the improvisation here with my right hand. And then instead of playing with both hands like this, I play like this for improvisation. So, and then, if you want, you can play. So, and while you are doing improvisation, you just keep the same bass pattern. Something like that. So, and this is the first time for me to work on this piece. Just specifically for this month, because I wanted to do something related to Miles Davis. But I thought a lot of harpists are making arrangement on a pop song, so I hope this video give you some good ideas you can use for your arrangement. I will continue make probably another video related to Miles Davis. Alright, thank you for watching. See you next time.